happy birthday to Jackson in Miss Eister's class and Andrew in Miss Stetter's room. On Saturday, happy birthday to Evelyn in Miss Lightner's room, McKenna in Miss Corky's room, Logan in Mr. Henning's room, and Isla in Miss Lisa's room. Today is National Shrimp Day. Shrimp are crustaceans. They are about 20,000 species, and they can be found in all oceans, in shallow and deep water, in fresh water lakes and streams. Many species are imported as food.
Our core value is commitment. What are examples of commitment? We can be committed to our studies. A work ethic is a willingness to put in the extra effort required to reach the goals that are expected of you. It can be something as simple as studying a bit longer, or it can be more complex, like sacrificing some of your own time to accomplish something. Being dedicated to your work is a powerful trait that shows you are committed to doing what is required to achieve your goals. Commitment is making a plan and putting it into practice.
Today in history, May 10th, 1869. The Transcontinental Railroad is completed. The Transcontinental Railroad unified the United States on May 10, 1869. The presidents of the Union Pacific and Central Pacific Railroads met in Utah and drove a ceremonial last spike into a rail line that connected their railroads. This made the Transcontinental Railroad travel possible for the first time in U.S. history. And no longer would Western-bound travelers need to take the long and dangerous journey by wagon train. Since at least 1832, both Eastern and Frontier statesmen realized a need to connect the two coasts. It was not until 1853, though, that Congress appropriated funds to survey several different routes for the Transcontinental Railroad. The actual building of the railroad would have to wait even longer, as the tensions between the North and the South prevented Congress from actually reaching an agreement on where the railroad would begin. 1 year into the Civil War, Congress passed the Pacific Railroad Act, which guaranteed public land grants and loans to the two railroads it chose to build the Transcontinental Line, the Union Pacific and the Central Pacific. With these in hand, the railroads began work in 1866. From Omaha and Sacramento, forging a northern route across the country. In their eagerness for land, the two lines built the railroad right past each other, and the final meeting place had to be renegotiated. Harsh winters and staggering summer heat, and the lawless, rough and tumble conditions of newly settled western towns made conditions for the Union Pacific laborers, mainly Civil War veterans, very miserable. The overwhelmingly immigrant Chinese workforce of the Central Pacific also had its fair share of problems, including brutal 12-hour workdays laying tracks over the Sierra Nevada mountains. On more than one occasion, whole crews would be lost to avalanches or mishaps with explosives. For all the adversity they suffered, the Union Pacific and Central Pacific workers were able to finish the railroad, laying nearly 2,000 miles of track by 1869, ahead of schedule and under budget. Their work had an immediate impact. The years following the construction of the railway were years of rapid growth and expansion for the United States, due in large part to the speed and ease of travel that the railroad provided.
And today's announcements by remembering to start expectations. Strive to do your best.
Take responsibility for your actions.
Always be safe.
Respect people and property.
Now please stand for the playing of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance.